Hello everyone, welcome to Green Learner. Today we are going to start a very new series that is about testing. So far in this video, in this channel, I have covered a lot about microservices source code, how you can put your business logic and integrate the different microservices patterns, right? But doing the source code and adding business logic is not sufficient for making the production ready services, right? Testing makes an integral part of that microservices development or any other application development, right? So in this series, I'm going to cover everything about microservices testing so that we can certify our service that it is ready to go to production, right? So in the bottom line, you can see there are different tools and things that we are going to use. So these are the things that I'm going to cover step by step to make it very easy and so that you can integrate in your application, in your microservice, right? So let's go ahead and get started. So before moving ahead, let's ask some questions to ourselves, right? So dev done, it means the source code is done. Is it ready for the production? So before going to production, you should ask these things, right? So you should consider about testing, whether you have covered all the test scenarios or not. Unit testing is very much important part of that, and then when you are done with the unit testing, code coverage comes into picture. So code coverage is the thing that measures your unit tests, right? So how many lines, how many conditions have you covered and how many you have missed. Effective unit testing, so when you have done unit testing and you have measured the code coverage, whatever testing and coverage that you are doing is correct or not. So that we are going to do with the effective unit test. Let me explain these things, unit testing, code coverage and other steps step by step. Unit testing, what is this? So I have taken all this definition from the internet directly. So unit testing is a level of software testing where individual units, components of a software are tested. So if I talk about the microservice, we have different endpoints, we have different services. So there are individual methods, right? M1, M2, M3. So these methods are units, individual units that we should test, right? And the purpose is to validate that each unit of a software performs as designed. So when you are writing a function, you have some expectation with that. So you pass some input and you get some output, right? So you have some predefined input output and pass that input to the method, and that output that is coming out of that function should be as expected that you have. So that we can test with this unit testing individually for all the methods. And a unit is the smallest testable part of any software. It usually has one or a few inputs and usually a single output. Right. So this is all about the software testing and microservices testing in general. So for our purpose, for microservices testing in Java, we are going to take advantage of this JUnit library that is available and used widely for the unit testing of the Java based projects. So we are going to explore this JUnit 5. Mocking is not different from the JUnit, so it is very much part of that, right? So but it is a different library that we use for the unit testing, right? So let's see what is this. So mocking is a process used in unit testing when the unit being tested has external dependency. So when you have microservice, right? So if this microservice is going to call another services, right, another things. So when you are doing the unit testing, you are not testing this external dependency. These are the external dependencies, right? So how you get the output, of these external dependencies in your microservice? So we take advantage of the mocking. Using mocking, we can mock the behavior. So what it is returning and what it is not returning, right? All of this is going to make more sense when we will see this in the demo part in the series of videos, right? So for now, just understand this. So mocking is for testing or isolating external dependencies. So the purpose is to isolate and focus on the code being tested and not on the behavior or state of external dependencies, right? So external dependencies we test in an integration test, right? So replacement for external dependencies, we can fake those dependencies, whatever is given here, we can stub those, we can mock those, right? So we can mock means we can give some input and mock the behavior that these are the inputs, you should behave this way only, there are no other behaviors, right? So we fix the output that external dependency is giving you, right? So this is the purpose of the mocking. Next, after And for mocking in Java, we are going to take advantage of the Mockito library, right? And code coverage after so with JUnit and Mockito, we have done the unit testing. Now it is time to measure the code coverage. How many lines, how many things we have covered in the unit testing part, right? So what is this code coverage? Code coverage is a measure which describes the degree of which source code of the program has been tested, right? We are going to use the Jacoco library with Java to measure the code coverage, right? And after that comes the SonarQubit itself. It is a tool. It is a library which gives you a user interface for many things to do. So let's see what we can get out of this SonarQube. We check the code quality from this. So we supply the source code and all those stuffs. It checks the quality of that. So it also detects the duplicate codes if there is any in your microservice. And it also checks for the coding standards. So there are some predefined rules with the SonarQube. And if you are writing the microservices, you test your microservices with SonarQube, it is going to suggest you improvements and suggest you the way the coding standard are followed, right? And you should follow that. And it also gives you the code coverage report very nicely. And security vulnerability at some extent is also measured out of this SonarQube, right? And there are different other features that SonarQube provides. And static code analysis is also provided by this SonarQube. So when we'll see this in demo SonarQube, it is going to make much more sense, and you will see how much advantage and how much beneficial it is for us to use in microservices. Then comes the mutation testing, right? So you're done with the unit testing, you are done with the Sonar, you are done with the code coverage, you have that, and you have 100%, 80%, 90% coverage. And then the things come, how correct your code coverage is, right? So, because that is also a tool, and it is correct or not. So when we are going to test those, we take advantage of this concept, mutation testing. Let's see what is this. Mutation testing is a type of software testing where we mutate certain statements in the source code and check if the test cases are able to find the errors. You have written the unit test against some business logic, right? And in future, if there is going to any change in those business logic, so your unit test should fail, right? Because that unit test was written for some earlier business logic and that had changed. So that is the way to check the effectiveness of the unit test. And if you're going to do this manually, that is pain point, right? So you cannot do that. So that is very difficult also, and not advised to do that. So this library, this concept, mutation testing, is coming to rescue in this case. When you are going to use this mutation testing libraries, it is going to do the changes in the source code runtime and check whether your tests, unit tests, are failing or not. If it is failing, it means your tests are good. If it is not failing, it means there are some problems, right? So you are not doing the correct unit testing. So in this case, we can identify those unit test cases that we have written and expected that it is testing our source code and business logic, but actually it is not testing, right? So this is going to provide us a nice user interface, a report, so that we can correct our unit tests, right? So this is the thing that mutation testing provides. This is the all about concept about this mutation testing. And this is, there are different libraries for the mutation testing to provide. And in the video series, in the tutorials, I'm going to take advantage of the PyTest, and I'll explore other options also. If it is there, I'll cover that also, right? So this is about the mutation testing. Next comes the integration testing. Integration testing tests the external dependencies as well. As I was talking about in unit testing, it was skipping the external dependencies. It was mocking that one, faking that one. But in integration testing, all the things are running properly, and we are doing the integration test for all those, right? So all the classes that are in your service, there are different layers in your integration, in your microservice, right? So you have controller, you have service, you have repository. So you are testing all of this in integration as one unit, right? That is the integration testing. But in unit testing, what you were doing, you were testing controller, you were testing service, you were testing repository separately, right? So this is the advantage of integration testing. So we are going to build a microservice with Spring Boot. So Spring Boot gives us the some libraries, some annotation to do the integration testing. We are going to take advantage of that, right? And this is the reference documentation that we will use. And this is the one page. You can take the screenshot of this and take note of this. We are going to cover all of this. First video series, I'm going to talk about the JUnit 5, that is the latest version of the unit testing for the Java. And then we are going to cover the Mockito, then we will cover the code coverage, Jacoco, and then we will integrate all of this with SonarQube, static analysis. We will show how we can do this, and then we will move ahead and see the integration testing. And in doing the integration testing, I'm also going to cover the cloud contract concept and then mutation testing. When all of this done, we are going to test whether our tests are fine or not, whether unit testing is fine or not. So this is the material for the next 1 or 2 months that I'm going to upload on this channel. So if you have not subscribed the channel, go ahead and subscribe this, and so that you can get the notification whenever I upload the video. So I'll try to cover this as soon as possible. If you're new to microservices and want to understand what are all these, right? So you can come to the channel and see. We have this microservices with Spring Boot. That is the big playlist, and you can get the understanding what is this all about. You can get understanding about other concept also, like Spring Boot caching, REST template, registry, load balancing, and all the rest of sites. And all of the source code that I have explained in all these videos are available on this GitHub repository. You can come here and see this also, right? So I hope, guys, you are going to learn something and you get understanding about the microservices testing that you should follow throughout this video, right? So I'm going to explain everything in detail in the future videos, right? So I hope to see you in the next videos.